So today we'll discuss about the most important concept in our data mining. So in cluster analysis, today we will discuss about the most important concept is hierarchical. So before going that hierarchical clustering, the drawbacks of the partition-based clustering can be overcome by using this hierarchical clustering. So drawbacks of the hierarchical clustering is drawbacks of the partition-based clustering is it cannot handle the large amount of sizes of data, and also identify the noisy outliers of the data is very difficult in partition-based clustering. So that's why we'll go for the hierarchical clustering. So basically, hierarchical clustering have the two popular algorithms are there. One is agglomerative clustering, second one is a divisive clustering. So in agglomerative clustering, basically agglomerative clustering can be implementing for to solve the non-globular shapes and different kind of individual cluster element to form a one cluster that can be implemented in agglomerative or hierarchical clustering. So it have the in algorithm itself we are using the agglomerative clustering. First of all, we compute the proximity matrix by the different kind of elements which are taking the input of the particular data set. So at each step we need to compute at each data point as should be cluster. So we repeat the steps until to match the two closest clusters and update the proximity matrix among them until only one single cluster should be formed for the set of points to be taken as input. So that is a basic agglomerative clustering algorithm which has implemented in a hierarchical modeling. So in agglomerative clustering, it is based on the equivalent distance formula. So if you need to calculate distance between the two points, we must consider about the distance d is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So this is the basic formula we are using for agglomerative clustering. So let us, I will, I am taking the simplest example. Let us suppose to we have the five different elements. Those are the five elements are A, B, C, D, E. These are five different individual elements. I need to take individual clusters, whereas implementing the agglomerative clustering. First, I need to compare about the distance between any two kind of clusters. The distance should be minimum. Then we will merge those two clusters and form a new cluster. Let us suppose that I consider A, B, C, D, E. These are the five different clusters. Out of these five different clusters, I need to check all the possibility conditions, the distance between any two kind of clusters will be minimum, so I need to match. So in a first step itself, AB is the distance is minimum, so I will match AB. After that, I will compare about AB cluster to C, AB cluster to D, AB cluster to E, otherwise C cluster to D, C to E, or D to E. So out of these all possibilities condition, D to E is a very closest cluster, thus also I will match D and E is a one cluster. After the C, I will calculate distance between the C cluster to DE, C cluster to AB. So C cluster DE distance is closest, so I will match CD. After that, AB is one cluster, CD is one cluster, so I will match ABCD. So finally, our object is we take the individual elements as the clusters, and finally we need to form a one single cluster with the containing of all individual point, individual clusters of the data set. So that is agglomerated clustering. Whereas agglomerative clustering can be also has two major things. One is single link and complete link agglomerative clustering. Single link and complete. So both clustering techniques are finally we are getting as output is we form only one cluster among the all individual points of the elements. Whereas divisive clustering in the reverse order of agglomerative, then we take the input of the grouped cluster that can be divided into multiple phases based on the steps. So until we need to reach the individual elements of the cluster. So that is called divisive clustering. So I already explained the contents of the agglomerative clustering. Basically, it is a single link and complete link agglomerative clusterings which are implementing in a hierarchical model. So before applying the single link or complete link agglomerative hierarchical clustering, first we have to understand about the individual points of the clusters. The individual points has to be taken as a clusters, or otherwise you need to compute the distance matrix or proximity matrix among the individual points. So I take the already, I computed the, in the problem statement itself, I am using the proximity matrix. Already we have the proximity matrix or distance matrix. So A, B, C, D are four individual elements. So based on these four individual elements, I need to compute the proximity distance among the all individual elements. That means distance from A to A, distance from A to B, distance from A to C, distance from A to D. Then distance from B to A, B to B, B to C, B to D. Distance from C to A, C to B, C to C, C to D. Distance from D to A, D to B, and D to C, D to D. So all these are four distances I need to calculate, and we form the matrix, we call it the proximity matrix. So based on the proximity matrix, we need to find out the, we need to apply the single link agglomerative clustering. As per our agglomerative clustering algorithm, the first step is to compute the proximity matrix among the individual points. After that, and we take the all individual points should be as individual clusters. So repeat the step, mesh the two closest clusters. After that, update the proximity matrix until only one single cluster should be formed. So this is the algorithm. So first we have take the three notations to form the cluster group. So let us, I consider D is a small, so small d is the depth of the hierarchical tree, small k is a cluster count, capital K is a cluster elements, and I'm writing the comments. So like that, you need to form the table. So initially I was taking the A, B, C, D is a individual point. These individual, each point should be taken as a cluster. So individual clusters. So let us here in a depth zero. So initially I'm taking the four clusters. So totally four. K, small k is equal to 4, and capital K is A, B, C, D. So we are writing the comment, we start with each point as a cluster. So this is the first step of the our model. So after that, we need to check the condition between the any two kind of cluster elements. If the distance is minimum, then we can say we can match all these two kind of clusters. So first I need to check with A to A, A to B, A to C, A to D. Otherwise B to C, B to D, otherwise C to D. All possibility conditions, distance between the A to B is equal to 1. It is a least distance, closest distance. So that's why we'll match. So match A and B because of distance of A comma B is equal to 1. So AB should be met, and we form AB is a one cluster, C is a separate cluster, D is a separate cluster. So how many clusters we are forming is 3 in level 1. Next, level 2. We need to once again, we'll check the conditions. So AB is a one cluster. The end point of the AB cluster is B. Some B to C and B to D, either C to D. So all these three possibilities, if the distance is very close, any one point is distance is closest, then we'll match. So compared to that, B to C distance is 2. B to D distance is 6. C to D distance is 3. So out of these three values, B to C distance is 2. So that's why distance of B to C is 2, then it is closest to the particular AB cluster. So AB cluster and C will be matched. So ABC is one cluster, D is one cluster. So we have to form two clusters. That is depth 2. And depth, finally, depth 3. So ABC is one cluster. So until one cluster should be formed in the our. So this is a final cluster we are forming from the model based on the ABC individual elements. So like that, you need to represent the dendrogram diagram for how to form a cluster, form a single cluster among the individual points of individual cluster elements of the data. So like that, single link agglomerative clustering algorithm can be implemented for a sample of data, that is ABCD as a sample of data points. So this is one thing we have to understand from the scenario. So after that, if you have any kind of points, that is a more number of points and more number of points should be taken as a cluster analysis process. So what is the starting situations when you form the having the more number of points should be taken as for this hierarchical clustering model? So anyhow, the starting point is we starts with each and every clusters as individual points, and we need to compute the proximity matrix for all the points which are given in our sample. So we are taking all elements as individual clusters. Based on these individual clusters, we need to compute the proximity matrix. So this is one. So after that, also we need to check the some of the merging steps with the some of the clusters. For example, here I am taking this four individual cluster, four clusters are five clusters are there. So I can compute the proximity matrix among the five clusters. So before merging the clusters, first I need to check the all the situations which are occurred in these based on the cluster as cluster's distance. So I need to check all the possibility conditions like that C1 to C2, C1 to C3, C1 to C4, C1 to C5 distances, either C2 to C3, either distance C2 to C4, C2 to C5, and C3 to C4, C3 to C5, either C4 to C5. All possibility conditions, if the distance is very closest, any kind of two clusters, then we'll merge. So that is a merging step we need to perform on the agglomerative hierarchical cluster. So this is a merging intermediate situation. Let us suppose that here C2 to and C5 distance is very closest. So that's why we will merge the these two clusters in a form of one cluster. C2 to C5 is a very closest distance. So we will merge C2 and C5 is one cluster. So that is intermediate situation. After merging C1, how many clusters we are forming is four. C1, C3, C4, and C2 and C5 both will be combined. We form one cluster. So after combining the cluster, what are the elements I need to consider for the this proximity matrix? So let us suppose that here is a very important thing. Some of the people may confuse that based on the selection of the inter-cluster similarity. So especially cluster analysis is a basic thing. It is based on the inter-cluster distance should be minimized. Inter-cluster distance should be minimized means the particular point is belongs to same cluster. Intra-cluster distance should be maximized means the point is belongs to other cluster. So here we are using minimum, maximum, group average, distance between centroids, or some other any kind of functions which can use to form the cluster elements. So for example, P2 and P5 as a closest distance. Let us support P2 and P5 as closest distance. We are merging P2 and P5. So P2 and P5 as a two values. Based on two values, we have calculated the minimum value. Minimum point should also be taken as a center node of the particular cluster. Otherwise, take the mean value or take the average value among the those two points. So based on that particular point, we need to compute the proximity matrix. So that is also possible in of the cluster similarities. So basically, for example, if you take the minimum value, so we have the two different clusters, distance between the two different clusters is maximum, that is minimum. So that is these two clusters will form one cluster. So that is case. For example, maximum value means the cluster will be distance is huge space. That is one cases. Group average, all the clusters we take a group average cluster element. So that is also one of the interdistance similarity we have to consider. Or otherwise, you take the centroids. For centroid to centroid distance, we have to calculate if the distance is closest, then we have to merge. So based on the all these four possibilities, we need to apply on two different kind of clusters. Let us, we have take the minimum or single link cluster. So, one second. Please mute the mic. Roll number 529, please mute your mic. One second. So let us, I consider the single link agglomerative clustering, either single link or minimum distance. Similarity of two clusters is based on the most similar cases or different kind of clusters. So for example, if it is determined one pair of points, so we are using the proximity graph among the one link only. That is a statement we are writing exactly here. For example, if you are forming A and B is one cluster, okay? A and B is one cluster. In single link, what we are considering, C is a separate cluster, and D is a separate cluster, and E is a separate cluster. Total 5 clusters are there. Out of these 5 clusters, AB cluster will be form one cluster. So AB have some values. Okay. For example, A is a sum 2 comma 3. A is 2 comma 3, and B is sum 5 comma 7. Let us suppose to B is 5 comma 3. 2 comma 3, 5 comma 3. So these are the two values for A and B. These two are matched. So out of these two values, A is a small value because of 3 is common for though. Here is 2 is very less value. So A is a lesser value. Whatever the matched cluster, the lesser cluster elements distance should be compared to other cluster elements. When you want to match for AB cluster with C or AB cluster with D, AB cluster with E. So we need to compute the proximity matrix like this. So A to C or A to D or A to E. So out of these three values, any value is distance is very small, then we will match. That is one case. Otherwise, C to D distance or C to E distance, that is also we need to compare. Otherwise, D to E distance. All these possibility conditions, if any one value distance is very small, then we will match. That is one case. Second is maximum value. Maximum value is B is a maximum value. So based on B to C, B to D, B to E, that is also you need to compare. So any value is very least value, then we will match it. That is second condition, minimum and maximum. Otherwise, average value. So average value is 3 plus 3 by 2. So this value considers average value. So based on this value also, you need to compute the distance among the C to D, C, D, E. For example, you have the 3.5 comma 3. So these are values are 3.5 comma 3. So based on this this value, you need to compute the distance among these to C, among to D, among to E. So out of these three values, distance is very closest, you can match. So minimum value you can take is, maximum value you can take is, average value you can take it to determine the, to compute the proximity graph among the those elements to form a cluster. So based on that, this is a thing we are having. So basically in single link, especially we need check about the only endpoint, the endpoint of the combined cluster. From endpoint to we have to compare all the remaining thing in single link. In complete link, we will check all the conditions checking the condition based on the depth. So that is the complete link. So this is the thing. So here I consider the one example for this. Let us suppose that I have the five different points are there. Out of these five different points, I already compute the distance matrix among them. Okay, distance matrix among them. Based on distance matrix, so first I need to check I1 to I2 distance is 0.90. I1 to I2 distance is 0.90. Okay. Next, here out of all these values, I1 to I2 distance or I1 to Wi-Fi distance also 0.20. I1 to Wi-Fi distance also 0.20. So you need to check all the conditions. I1 to I5, all the distance 0.90, 0.10, 0.65, 0.25. If you take as a proximity graph based on the closest in the points of different clusters. Closest is actually I1 to I1 distance is 1.0. So 1.0 closest value is 0.90 is the closest value. So 1.0 highest value. I2 to I2 also 1.0, I3 to 1.0, I4 is 1.0, I5 to I5 is 1.0. So I1 distance is closest value is 0.90. So that's why we'll match I1 and I2. After that, I4 and I5, check the I4 and I5. I4 distance is 0.80. Okay, I5 to I4 is also 0.80. So both will be matched. They are closest with each other. 4 and 5 will match. Then after that, I2 distance is 0.0 I3. So that is called I3. So we can consider as an average value 1.9 by 2. That is something we consider say from 0.9 something we are getting. So I1, I2, and I3. I3 is a very closest value to the I1, I2. So then I3 we are matched. After that, these two are should be matched because of we need to form one cluster. So I1, I2, I3, I4, I5 will be matched among them. So like that we need to match. So I will check here. We are considered based on minimum. So first is I consider I3 and I6. Because of it is minimum. Let us suppose that minimum distance. Then I5 to I2 is second cluster. Then remaining both two are the two clusters should be form one three cluster third cluster. Then I4 is a one cluster nested cluster, and I1 is a nested cluster. That is five. So like that you need to form the hierarchical clustering by using the minimum distances. So the strength of the minimum is actually the original points are like we are representing the original point of the clusters like this. If you need to form the two clusters, so we have to separate the those points into two clusters. So based on the minimum distances. Otherwise, if you have the non-elliptical shapes of the images or image points, it is very difficult to it is very difficult to identify the cluster, but we can handle non-elliptical shapes also in hierarchical model by using minimum distance. So let us suppose the limitation of minimum distance. See, some of the points are noisy and outliers. So the noisy and outliers data can be handled sensitively because of they are forming one cluster group, separate cluster group. So especially we are taking all original points. Based on these original points, we need to form two clusters. So based on minimum distance only we are taking. So when you separating the each and every individual points as a cluster, some noisy and outlier data also should be inherited of the cluster element. So that is one of the limitations of the very easy. That is called complete link, using the maximum distances among the of two clusters is if two clusters similarity is based on the two different clusters. Similar most distant points of the different clusters we are using. So here I can consider the maximum distance among them, max formula or complete link. So in complete link, what you need to check all the conditions. So based on the conditions, that is the most distinct points which are different from the clusters that should be formed. So here also our final objective is all the clusters should be formed one cluster only. All individual clusters should be formed only one cluster. So based on all possibility conditions, we have to check among the distances of the particular scenario. So based on the distances, first we have to check the conditions like I1 and I2 as very closest. Then we have to match, and I4 and I5 are also very closest. Then we are matched. Then after that, I3 should be matched because of we are comparing all the distances among them. So after that, we have to match 5. So based on the maximum distance or complete linkage we can use for cluster similarity. So let us here, I will explain with maximum distance. For example, If the distance between i3 to i6 is one cluster will form. So after that, i2 and i5 is one cluster, second cluster. i3 first cluster and third cluster should be formed by using i4. Then after that, first cluster and second cluster and fourth cluster will form. Then after that, all these clusters should be formed one cluster. So nested cluster structure, which is based on the maximum distance among the different kind of individual cluster elements. So like that, we are applying the maximum. Then what is the strength of the maximum cluster? It is susceptible that is noisy or outliers which are there in the original points. We are easy to find out that because of based on the distance is maximum. So we need to identify that is a individual cluster or separate cluster. We are identify that. So basically, maximum distance will support the identify about the noisy and outliers. So it is less susceptible because of it will form a separate group clusters in the model. Next one, if you take a cell, what is the limitations is? It is for larger kind of data sets or larger kind of clusters. This max cluster similarity, it is not possible because of it will take a lot of time to produce the results. So it will break large clusters we need to form. So it is also biased towards about the global clusters which is formed in the model. So that is also one of the limitations which is using for the max cluster similarity. Then third one is a very important is group average. So based on the cluster, when you compute the proximity matrix, we need to collect the group average of the cluster. So group average is based on the two different kind of clusters should be formed in the model. So it is to calculate the used to average connectivity of scalability since total proximity flavors in the large clusters. So that is also one of the important technique which is applied in a group average. So first we need to calculate the average of after forming of the cluster group. So based on the average value, we need to compute the distance approximately matrix for individual clusters. So then after that, we need to check the condition once again and check the distance between the two clusters is minimum. So we have met it. After that, we have formed the nested cluster, then form nested cluster, then form nested cluster. So until all the cluster elements will form one cluster group, we form the by using this group average concept. So these are three very important techniques is applied in when you form the cluster elements in hierarchical modeling. Then in a group average is it is compromised with the single link and complete link, especially because of single link will follow one thing and complete link will follow another mechanism. In single link, we need to check the distance between endpoint of the group cluster to the all remaining points. If distance is minimum, you are matched. Whereas complete link, we have to check all the condition possibilities based on depth value. It will depth value less than or equal to condition, then only we'll match. That is a group average. So the strength of the group average is less susceptible noise and outliers of data which are there in the original data set. That is also strength. Limitations is it is biased towards global clusters elements. It cannot form the hierarchical model. So these are the things we have to understand from the group average. So one more important technique is applied in the cluster similarity, that is called Wards method. So Wards method is one of the most important powerful technique which are employed to increase the square error among the two clusters are to be merged. Because of we are dealing with all the distance problem by using equivalent distance. Equivalent distance d is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. All the values we need to compute square values. So based on the square values, we have the sum of the floating point values also there. So if you need to calculate the floating point distance to the among remaining points, it will take some of the values are inaccurate. So that case is it is less susceptible noise and outliers can be occurred in the cluster similarity. So based on this one, hierarchical clustering is analog that is also used in initialize of k-means clustering algorithm, which is to solve this cluster similarity. For example, comparisoning of all these four. In first words method, we have to consider three and six are very close, then we form one cluster. Then after that, here also maximum also 3, 6, minimum also 3, 6, and group error is also 3, 6. Then we consider 5, 2 is second cluster. Here is 5, 2. Here is 5, 2. Here is also 5, 2. Then third step is major important step. Here 4, 3 is one. 4, 3, 3, 6, and 4 is one cluster. Here same. Here also same. Here also. Here also different. So these two clusters should be form as a one cluster. Then after that, here fourth cluster. Then here remaining all four elements is one cluster. Here remaining element is one cluster. Here remaining element is one cluster. Finally, all elements should be formed in another clusters. So this is a way minimum, maximum, group average, words method can be working to form individual elements form as one single cluster among the data. So hierarchical method can be applied for four ways, either minimum, maximum, group average, or words method you can use to form the cluster elements. So that is a time space requirement of the hierarchical clustering is order of n square is a space because of we are using the proximity matrix, using the proximity matrix to compute the proximity matrix. So n is the number of points which are using the our hierarchical clustering method. So order of n square is a space because of it uses the proximity matrix in the particular hierarchical clustering algorithm. So n is the number of points. Whereas order of n cube times many cases like there are n steps for each step size is each step in the size. N square is a proximity matrix must be updated and searched. So that complexity can be reduced to order of n square into log of n times for the sum of the approaches. Order of n square into log of n is a time complexity for sum of the approaches we are using in hierarchical clustering. Because of in algorithm itself, when we take the input is proximity matrix. After that, we take the all individual points should be as individual clusters. So repeat the step. Merge the two closest cluster, update the proximity matrix. So this is a statement is very, very important. Update the proximity matrix. If you want to update the proximity matrix, once again, you need to recompute the all cluster elements, then only until when you form one single cluster. So it will take a lot of time when you update in the proximity matrix. So that case is the complexity of the reduced to order of n square into log of n is a time complexity for some of the approaches using the hierarchical method. So this is the time and space requirements of the hierarchical clustering. So basically, hierarchical clustering has the problems and some of the limitations. So different situations are different kind of data, different kind of schemas we are applying on hierarchical clustering, which have the more number of problems. First problem is sensitivity on identify about noisy and outliers of data which are found in the databases. Difficulty handling different sized clusters or convex shaped in a model. That is also one of the problem. So a major problem is to breaking the larger clusters into groups. It is very difficult. So these are the problems are facing by the hierarchical clustering. So some of the limitations, for example, once decision is made to combine two clusters, so it cannot be undone. After completion, after merged it, we cannot divide those two clusters in separated. So that is one of the problem. So once objective function is directly minimized, no objective function is directly minimized, we cannot use that. So that is all. What are the criteria? If you take is a minimum and you take a minimum values for among the merging of two clusters, so that is the things we need to follow all the steps until one single cluster should be formed in the scenario. So these are the problems and limitations of the hierarchical clustering. So basically, Hierarchical clustering have the basic problems is sensitivity to noise, identify the noisy and outliers of data. Secondly, it is handling the data size clusters instead of they have some of the convex shapes or some of the spherical shapes of the data, also very difficult. Breaking the large clusters into groups, breaking the is one of the major problem in hierarchy. So, whereas a divisive clustering is one of the most important clustering algorithm in hierarchical modeling, the divisive clustering can be implemented by using the minimum spanning tree. So, minimum spanning tree is a principle is applied in divisive clustering. So, starts with the tree consists of any point. So, in successive steps, look the closest pair of points, such as one point is a current tree, another other point is not a tree. But when the queue is added in a tree, put edges in between the P and Q. So that is the things which is happening on divisive hierarchical clustering. So I will explain in detail to you the algorithm. So divisive hierarchical clustering will follow the four steps. The first step is, first we need to compute the minimum spanning tree based on the proximity graph. That is, first we take all individual points. Based on the individual points, we need to compute the proximity matrix. So based on the proximity matrix, you need to compute the minimum spanning tree. So repeat, they create a new cluster by breaking the link corresponding to the largest distance. Corresponding to the largest distance instead of smallest similarity. Corresponding to the largest distance, then only form a new cluster. Until only single cluster remains. Until only single cluster should remains. So that is called divisive clustering algorithm. So see the example, I will explain in detail to you. Let us suppose that ABCD is a grouped cluster. ABCD is a grouped cluster. So this is one cluster. So based on this cluster, first we have to compute the proximity matrix among these four values. So based on the proximity matrix. So first we need to check the distance among the each and every individual elements, and we form the spanning tree, minimum spanning tree. So based on the minimum spanning tree, create a new cluster from the breaking the link corresponding to the largest distance. So out of these four elements, for example, A to B distance is large, or B to C, A to D, or B to C, B to D. From the all the elements, if the distance are very largest, then we will separate a D cluster. Let us, for example, A, B, C is one cluster. D cluster will be distance is large. So these two are separate cluster will form in first step. After that, from ABC cluster two, need to check all the conditions. Distance are large, then AB is one cluster, and C is a separate cluster, and D is a separate cluster. Then from after that, AB also will be divided into group. AB is one cluster, C cluster, and D cluster. Like that, we need to follow step by step process until all elements should be as a single cluster. One single cluster should be remain in the particular group. So this is a mechanism which is applied in the divisive hierarchical clustering technique. So basically, hierarchical clustering algorithm has two types, agglomerative and divisive. Agglomerative clustering has single link and complete link, or minimum, maximum, or average, or Ward's principle. All these kind of techniques applied for single link or complete link agglomerative clustering. Whereas divisive clustering, only one thing we are following to create the minimum spanning tree based on the proximity graph. So after that, create a new cluster by breaking all corresponding large distance based on the smallest similarity until only one cluster should be remained. So this is a thing we are applying for divisive hierarchical clustering technique.